You showed skill making it to our central command, Wind Vestal. But unfortunately for you, you won't get any further if I can help it. I'm in fine form today. I'll show you how weak and pathetic you...
Victoria!
Victor! I can't... Please!
Last year proved more unstable than I had feared. We must seek treatment at once!
Victor.
Silence, if you please. She would likely perish if we were to disturb her now.
It's happening again.
Again? What do you mean?
Oh, I was just thinking out loud.
Allow me to tell you a story, if I may. Once upon a time, in a place not of this land, there was an orphan child suffering an incurable disease. Her name was Victoria. Though still a child, she was abhorred by those around her due to her affliction, as the Orthodoxy cast her aside. She was taken in and raised by the Orthodoxy soon after her birth. She simply waited upon her inevitable demise, all the while gasping in pain and despair. Then, a chance meeting changed her life. On death's door and abandoned, she was found by the Grand Marshal, who wandered the lands after renouncing the Orthodoxy himself. She began her treatments in this land after the Lord Marshal conquered and renamed it the Duchy of Eternia. It was I who created the White Magic Cable. I was charged with studying the combined use of white magic and the crystals. I advocated the use of treatments by amplified white magic on her. But there was one who voiced objections. My assistant in my white magic research, Vincent S. Cort, my father. He pressed endlessly for an alternate treatment, one not based on the amplification of white magic. But it was alchemical genesis he proposed. It is a forbidden art, a foul heresy, banned since the time of the old faith. The Lord Marshal and I both rejected my father's proposal out of hand, but he would not be swayed. He didn't so much as ask Victoria's consent. He believed his cure had rid her of her affliction, but the truth was far different. It stilled her growth, and periodic fits grew more frequent. Soon, it began to cripple even her mind. My father has since passed. She found clarity one day. return to herself. She murdered him. I was devastated. No, in truth, I was already a broken man. You must think me a fool for not loathing my father's murderer. But I could not exact vengeance on her. I was entranced by her innocent eyes and childlike form. I devoted myself, body and soul, to her healing. Yet, I failed to relieve her suffering. Each time her tiny form is racked with pain, I ask myself, knowing the result, would I still have intervened as I did? But ever is my answer the same. As long as I draw breath, I will see that she does too. No matter how she suffers, I'll not allow her to die. She is both my crime and my redemption. My ego, my joy. I dedicate my entirety to her. And know no greater pleasure.
What nonsense. I mean, really, Victor. That was so boring and really long, too.
Forgive me, Victoria. How do you fare now?
Back to my old self. But I don't think I could take another one of those fits. Now, let's take care of these fools once and for all.
Your wish is my command.
Stop it! What is the point of us fighting?
The point, you ask? Because you disgust me, Idea. That is reason enough to fight? No. I wish to see your corpses flayed before me, fools!
Thank you.
You. I don't remember doing anything to you.
But of course you don't. You have your help and blood relatives that care for you deeply. You live a life of comfort with many friends and teachers. And yet despite these blessings, you rebel. How can you display such arrogance, Adia? I find your very existence offensive. I fail to see how that is justified. Is that right? You have no concept of the suffering of us have-nots. Justified or not, I despise you. Why don't you just roll over and die now? Treatment will stop. The next fit I have will be my last. So, with the short time I have left, I'd like nothing more than to crush you all!
Yeah. Yeah. You came. I've already taught you all I know. Now it is time for us to part. You must go forth guided by your own will. To learn who you are, what you are capable of, and what you can endure. The road ahead will be hard and bitter, no doubt. Have you the resolve to persevere?
Yes.
Very well. We will begin with an alternate fate for Ringabel. A man laments alone in Edea's chamber. Go to him.
Let my body be rent in two, and the world come to an end. I care not, but why? Tell me! Why? Why did you have to die? Answer me, Edea.
So, in this world, Edea is...
Alternus.
Whatever may happen, I care. You're Me. You're me from back when I had nothing. I dared to ask for something, then lost all I'd found. And now you've come to end me. Very well. Nothing remains for me. I'll die by your hand. Or any other.
No! Alternus, listen!
It's no use. He's blind with grief. Here he comes!
Thank you.
Crystal's blessing!
Putrid reek of decay, muddy waters, hunger, scorn. My earliest recollection always starts there. Abandoned by my mother at a tender age, I've always been alone, for as long as I can remember, always dancing on the razor's edge between life and death, and always have I hated my mother, my circumstance, the world, myself. At a young age, I gained the powers of darkness, and hatred was my sustenance. Then one day, my sword of hate and rage was turned aside by one who wielded a kind and just blade. The Templar saved me. He gave me a righteous rebuke, a kind family. I vowed to serve him and no other. I would lay my life down for his ideals, stake my being upon protecting those he loved. And yet, I failed.
Alternus.
I've no more need for this. This power couldn't even protect Idea.
Are you so sure? Without darkness, you'll...
It's too late, all of it. I can't return to the forces, to the council. It matters not. Take it. Take it and go in my stead. Do this for me.
Ring a bell. You are not of this world, nor are you of the world from which the other three hail. There is nowhere else you can call home, nowhere left to return. The Templar who took you in despite your dark past, those who accepted you as family, the one you love, all are denizens of another place. A world that is not your own. But with the departure of your counterpart in this world, you may now remain here if you so choose. There is a place here for you. What will you do?
I don't...
You need not decide right away. Think upon it. Now... Here is an alternate fate for Idea. A man and his wife mourn their daughter's death at the central healing tower. Go to them.
Thank you. Who you are! How dare you come here in the guise of my daughter!
Bye.
Let's end this quick!
Thank you. That swordsmanship, it is a mirror to Kami Izumi's own. Then you are a deer.
A deer? Is it truly you? Oh, what a joy to see you live.
We heard you'd perished. Oh, your father and I were beside ourselves.
Your sword was sent back to us. To remember you by. I cannot express the joy. Dear, my daughter lives.
I'd given up hope that you'd ever return to us.
And to think she would defeat me. Truly, the girl is her father's daughter.
Your father saw the promise in you, more than anyone. He rested his dreams on your perseverance. And when word came of your passing, oh, he grieved you more than any.
Father.
Forgive me for never putting it in words. Duty and circumstance hindered me at every turn. But still.
No, I understand, Father. And let me ask your forgiveness for being the willful child that I am.
And you, Alternus. It was you who brought Adia back safely to our side.
I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Ever have you been a boon to this family?
Oh, no. I'm not...
When was the last time we enjoyed a meal together? Tonight? Let us dine as a family.
I don't remember the last time.
Nor do I.
Edea's counterpart in this world perished in Caldisla. Edea, ring a bell. You too may remain here in this world. These roles are yours to take, should you so choose. A life of peace awaits, a family. And for a once grieving mother and father, a life of comfort, free from loss. What will you choose, Edea? You needn't be hasty. Think upon it. Now, for you, Agnes. In a remote village west of Florum lives a maiden in fear of her appointed task and the enemy on her heels. Go to her.
Thank you. Victoria and that man Victor attacked. You tried to protect me and I thought I would never see you again. I'm overjoyed to see that you yet live. Thank you. Thank you. Olivia, I... Promise you'll never leave my side again.
Vestal of Water, you've nowhere to run.
That voice... I'm here, ya.
The Wind Vestal is already dead. That leaves only you, Olivia. All hope of reviving your precious crystallism is lost. The end is plain to see.
We've sealed off any means of escape, sister.
Nowhere to run.
You heard them. Now surrender at once, or face the consequences.
I'm here, ya. And both of your sisters in tow.
So, you've come, Medea. You've made it clear you intend to defy us at every turn. So be it. Prepare yourself!
Thank you.
take my aid!
I saved this for you. You've grown strong, Hedia.
Einherja, are you hurt?
I'm fine.
Artemia, take over from here. No one get by.
No. We go together. I'll not lose my sisters over that philanderer's orders. I am impressed, Adia. Though we fall back now, I will settle this score someday.
I hear ya. They're gone. Are you all right? Olivia? I'm scared. So scared. Olivia!
Don't you leave me, Agnes. Say you'll stay with me. It will be the two of us together from now on. We'll fulfill our appointed task together. We're friends, after all. We'll be fine so long as we have each other. I need no longer be afraid.
Agnes.
Though she speaks of fulfilling the Vestal's task together, I suspect you know well enough. It is not as she imagines it. Still, it is a road you may choose, should you so wish. Agnes, this world's Vestal of Wind has passed on, but you may remain here as Agnes Oblige, friend of Olivia. What will you do? Will you choose a restful life together?
I need...
You need not answer now. At last, we come to you and your fate, Tiz. In a ruined village, there is a young lad in a daze. Go to him.
Look at this place. No one's rebuilt anything yet.
Tiz?
Brother! It is you!
Till! You survived!
Tiz!
Till!
But you died! You tried to protect me, and you...
Till... I never thought I'd hear your voice again.
I've been all alone since I lost you. I tried to rebuild the village, but couldn't do it alone. Airships came after me, and I was attacked by the strangest pair!
Forgive me, Till. Forgive me for leaving you all alone.
Tiz! Behind you!
What now?
Pushed me clear as the ground collapsed. Had I just kept hold of your hand... I kept playing that moment over and over again in my mind. It's been eating me up inside.
Till...
But you're back again to save me. My big brother. My hero. Please, don't leave me ever again. We'll rebuild the village together. The king says he'll help. It might take years, but we'll have it back just the way it was.
Right. Let's do that.
Tiz.
Your counterpart in this world perished saving his younger brother. If you wished to stay and live here, there is now a place for you. A place where you fit in. And perhaps your brother will finally be free of the terrible memory that haunts him. A specter you yourself are all too familiar with, I'm sure.
I wish...
Your decision needn't be a rash one. Speak amongst your comrades before you decide. I will await you in Yuliana Woods. Come see me when your decision is made.
It is not for me to remain as Vestal here in this world.
That's right. You're the Vestal of Wind, Agnes. You can't end your journey here!
And Olivia? You'd be condemning her to the same loneliness and dread you felt in the first world.
The same could be said for you, Tiz. Do you intend to leave your brother all alone?
Well, even if you two don't stay, I think Edea should remain here with her mother and father.
What about you, Ringabel? You'd lost your memory for such a long time. Now you finally have somewhere to go. People who love you. I can't stay here by myself.
I'll go wherever you do, Agnes.
Though the world may change, you never do. Not once since that moment on the brink of the Great Chasm.
We battled the Sky Knights together. Then we weathered the burning of Caldisla.
I asked you to take me with you. Then we met, Edea.
We stole the Echelot and awakened the Wind Crystal in Anshime.
Then to Florum and the Sacred Flower Festival. We lost Olivia, but awakened the Water Crystal.
We worked together to save Aegle and Eisenberg. Remember how Agnes's face got all covered in soot?
I hardly see how that detail is relevant now.
But it was hilarious. And then there were all the fights before then, too.
We have our answer, then?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Seems so.
All right, then. Let's go see the sage.